What up, Liptards? You foolish Liptards. What you gonna do, big boy? What you gonna do, big boy? People often tend to ask me why I prefer television shows to movies. Well, the reason for that is when you have an, let's say, hour and a half long or 2 hour or 3 hour long film, it's very hard to tell a complicated, deep and interesting story with a lot of twists and turns without sacrificing the characters and making them shallow and one-dimensional. And also the same is for vice versa. However, when you have a television show that is, let's say, 10 episodes or 20 episodes or 50 or 100 episodes long, you have much more freedom to tell as complex of a story and as long of a story as you want, while also giving us deep, interesting, and not one-dimensional characters. However, that wasn't always the case. See, for the longest time, people didn't really take television shows that seriously. They were usually either only sitcoms or shows that really didn't have that much complexity to them. However, that all changed once David Lynch and Mark Frost got together to create Twin Peaks. Now for the next few videos, I'm going to be talking about the original two seasons of the show that ran from 1990 to 1991, Fire Walk With Me, which is a prequel slash sequel film, and then I'm going to talk about The Return, which is basically season 3 that aired in 2017. Now I'm going to split this into three videos because all three of these are significantly different. Now before I begin, I'm gonna give you a brief synopsis of what the show is actually about. The show starts with the murder of Laura Palmer. She is a homecoming queen in a small town in the mountains called Twin Peaks, which starts an ongoing investigation which lasts for almost the entirety of the two seasons. And the story really kicks off once an FBI agent named Dale Cooper comes in to help the local sheriff in this investigation. They form a friendship, and throughout most of the story and throughout most of the show, it's about them slowly uncovering clues about who murdered Laura Palmer, while at the same time new and different side plots and side mysteries, you know, occur and get solved. Now the original vision that Mark Frost and David Lynch had for this show was to never reveal who killed Laura Palmer. Now maybe they would have revealed it at the very end of the show, but the point was to always constantly have this looming mystery that never really gets resolved, while constantly giving us these new and smaller mysteries that will constantly get solved. However, the studio pushed David Lynch and Mark Frost to reveal who the killer was, after which one of the creators, David Lynch, left, which I will get into later. After that, for a few episodes, the show kind of stumbled about and didn't really know what to do, and there wasn't really much of a focus. However, the focus kind of returned once a character named Wyndham Earl appeared, who has a deep and personal connection to Dale Cooper, and that kind of gives the story some new direction and meaning, which kind of gives the story some new focus. Now before I get into really why this show fell apart and why people lost interest and why it eventually got canceled after the second season, I want to talk about one more thing that makes this show really good, and that is the fact that it combines a lot of different genres. Like first and foremost, this is a crime thriller, being that it's, you know, revolving around a murder mystery. However, at the same time, it has a lot of really funny and interesting characters who bring a much lighter and more comedic tone. One being, you know, the main character, Dale Cooper, who, even though he is an FBI agent, he is a very fun, eccentric, and really weird character who loves, you know, coffee and pie, and who is overall a very charming and interesting character. However, this show also has a lot of horror elements. Now, aside from having some really weird and sometimes downright terrifying characters and some really horrifying scenes, it's also horror because of some of the subject matter that this show deals with. Even though, yeah, the show does often have a very light and comedic tone, This show is mainly about a murder of a girl who, even though on the surface seemed like a perfect teenager, everyone loved her, she dealt with a lot of dark things. Throughout this investigation, we learn a lot of dark secrets that she held.
February 22nd. Last night I had the strangest dream. I was in a red room with a small man dressed in red and an old man sitting in a chair. I tried to talk to him. I wanted to tell him who Bob is because I thought he could help me. But my words came out slow and odd. It was frustrating trying to talk. I got up and walked to the old man. Then I leaned over and whispered the secret in his ear.
Now, aside from the actual investigation, another big focus of the show were the other characters, the other townspeople, who we got to meet and really see how much Laura Palmer's death impacted all of them, while also seeing how these characters impacted her death, and how basically almost every single one of the characters had something indirectly to do with her death. See, because this show takes place in a very small town, which means it's a very small community and everyone knows each other, which makes her death personal for every single one of them, which we wouldn't really be able to get in any other film. If Twin Peaks was a movie, yeah, sure, we would kind of get some perspective of other people, but we wouldn't get such a deep look into every single person in this town. And that was basically the driving force behind most of the show. However, unfortunately, the studio decided to mangle, and they forced David Lynch and Mark Frost to reveal the killer and basically wrap up that entire story. And that was one of the major reasons that this show died. Now, let me really explain why that is a big problem. Now, if you haven't seen this show, you're probably wondering why that would be a big deal. I mean, having one murder mystery last an entire show is kind of complicated to do because, you know, it's very hard to keep it constantly fresh. However, in order to really explain that, I'm going to compare this to another show, to an anime called One Piece. Now, if you've seen any of these shows, you're probably wondering, what the fuck does an anime about pirates have to do with a murder mystery? In order to really explain that, I'm gonna have to give you a brief summary of what One Piece is about. One Piece is basically about this treasure called One Piece, which is hidden somewhere in the world. No one knows what it is, no one knows where it is, and no one knows what it does. But what everyone knows is whoever finds this treasure will basically rule the world, which made a bunch of pirate crews go out into the sea and search for this treasure, one of which being our main protagonist. However, the show isn't really about them searching for the One Piece. It's more about the adventures that they have along the way. Now, this show has been going on for more than 20 years, and it is still ongoing. So it's a big fucking mystery how a show that is basically about a crew of pirates going out on different adventures, how this show managed to keep such a popularity for such a long time. And the answer to that question is because of One Piece, because of this big looming overarching story that basically, you know, connects all of these different adventures together. Now imagine if creator of One Piece one day decided to wrap up the entire story of One Piece, to reveal what the One Piece is, you know, and to basically wrap up the main story. And then after that, instead of, you know, finishing One Piece, he decided to keep going by making just, you know, once again, these, you know, random adventures that the crew, you know, comes across. Now, on the surface, the show would technically still be the same. They would still go on different adventures and not much would be different. However, without this, you know, end goal, without this overarching, you know, looming story, a lot of fans would quickly lose interest. And that is exactly what happened to Twin Peaks. See, once this main mystery of who killed Laura Palmer ended, people really weren't that interesting to see where the show was gonna go next.
No, that man I saw, long, dirty, disgusting hair.
He's gone. Forever.
So is everything I loved.
And now the second main reason why this show died was due to the departure of David Lynch. See, David Lynch was very pissed when he had to reveal the death of Laura Palmer. This was a show that meant a lot to him, and this mystery and Laura Palmer as a character was something that meant a lot to Lynch. He wanted to do so much more with her character. He wanted to explore so much more of her character. However, he couldn't do that because he was forced to prematurely ejaculate the truth about the killer of Laura Palmer, which left him really heartbroken, and he got pissed and he left the show, leaving only Mark Frost to pick up where the show left off. Now, here's the problem with that. A big reason for the success of this show was really the collaboration between these two creators. Now, David Lynch is a very artsy director. His films are usually very weird. He uses a lot of surreal imagery that doesn't have any clear explanation. On the other side, Mark Frost is someone who is deeply interested in a lot of different mythologies, and that is really his forte. And both of these creators bring something to the table, and when they're combined, they create something amazing. For instance, David Lynch creates a lot of weird imagery.
Why, we're from the birds sing a frosty song. And there's a voice music in the air.
And then Mark Frost comes in, and he makes sense out of all of these weirdness that David Lynch created. And he kind of, you know, he kind of uses his knowledge of different mythologies to connect that to the weird and to the weird ideas that David Lynch has. And that is sort of the synergy that these two have, you know, constantly playing off one another. And that is really what makes Twin Peaks as a show really interesting and fun. However, once David Lynch left, that was no longer the case. Once David Lynch left, that aspect of this show was completely gone, and Mark Frost didn't really have much to work with. He did try to do some of the things like David Lynch, you know, to create some scary, weird imagery, but he never really managed to do that as good.
What happened to Josie?
And aside from all of that weirdness, another thing that was lost to the show was really the dark and horror element of the show that I was talking about before. Now, Mark Frost did try to, you know, keep that sort of, you know, dark atmosphere at the certain moments, you know, especially with the character of Linda Merle. You know, he really did try his best to make him, you know, really weird and scary. However, he never really managed to do that. He never really managed to capture that truly horrific tone and this truly horrific look into human nature that David Lynch did. So basically, after David Lynch departed, the show was mostly a comedy, which was something that was kind of, you know, really unsettling for me, because it is really a show which in its core is about a teenager getting raped and murdered that has now turned into basically a comedy with some serious elements. Now, you're probably wondering whether you should even watch the show after Laura Palmer's death and all of that storyline gets wrapped up, which I believe is like at the 9th episode of the second season. And my answer to that is yes, you should keep watching. One of the main reasons for that is the last episode. The last episode is where we see the return of David Lynch. And that is, in my opinion, and in the opinion of a lot of other people, the best episode of the show. It returns to us all of the things that we were missing after David Lynch left. Okay, so, you know, to kind of wrap up, The first season of the show is really good. It gives you an introduction to all of the characters and makes you really invested into the story. The first 9 episodes of season 2 are basically the best part of the story. They focus very much on the investigation of Laura Palmer, while also giving us a few side stories. Most of the beginning of season 2 is directed by David Lynch, and you know, every episode that's directed by him is really good. And the show has a really strong focus, and there a lot of interesting things happen in that part. However, after that gets wrapped up until the last episode, you know, it gets worse, but it never really becomes terrible. Like, maybe for a few episodes, but once Winder Merle appears, you know, the show does get, you know, some new tempo, and it does get a new focus, and it does overall become better than it was for those few episodes. So it's not that terrible, it's just nowhere near as good. However, due to the last episode being as amazing as it is, you can almost forgive it for having these bad episodes. So if this review interested you in watching the show in any way, I do suggest you watch it before watching my Far Walk With Me review. It's a really good show, and I would recommend it to anyone who is a fan of film, is a fan of television shows, and is basically a fan of a good murder mystery. Yeah, that's it.